Santa Sue. I'm Jonavie DeMerla.
And I'm Selena Driver. It's the first KSSH News episode of the new year.
And the beginning of the second semester. A second chance to get it right.
That sounds like a good New Year's resolution, Jonavie.
I don't bother making them because I don't want to break them.
Hey Santa Sue, Margaret Rowe here, leading off the new year, asking what your New Year's resolutions are.
My New Year's resolution was to not misplace my keys as often this year.
Our New Year's resolution, we've decided to give up beans.
Is to get good grades this semester.
In the rap game, you know, the keys to make it.
My New Year's resolution is to grow taller.
Get a puppy.
To be healthy.
To go on my phone less.
I'm gonna stop binge watching Netflix.
My New Year's resolution is to get better friends.
I don't have one.
To graduate and to learn how to pronounce it.
Is to have a more positive outlook on life, and the other one is to have more chill.
Did you break your New Year's resolution?
On the second day we both did, yes.
Broken what?
No.
Have you broken it?
I sure did.
Have you?
Nah.
Graduate.
Well, not yet.
I'm a lyrical, miracle, spiritual individual. The lyrical, spherical, miracle individual. I'll be skipping and flipping and dipping and flipping and skipping.
Cutting it a little short this year.
It's okay. I know.
Graduate.
Hey,
yes,
oh,
you
yeah,
did it.
I did it.
Have you broken it?
Both of them in the first hour.
My resolution is to never let Margot dupe me into getting on camera again.
Have you broken it?
Yes.
We have a new psychologist on campus.
Hey there, Santa Sue. Robert Garcia here. Many of you may not know that we have a new psychologist this year named Carrie Murphy, who does things like counsel students, work with special ed, and various other services for our school. Let's go talk to him. Why did you become a school psychologist?
It began with my mother being a school psychologist. When I was in college, the job sounded interesting to me. I interviewed a number of other school psychologists, found out what the job was like, how they work with kids. I enjoy working with kids at both the elementary and high school level.
What were you doing before you came to Santa Sue?
I was a school psychologist at Royal High School in Simi Valley for the last 30 years.
What do you do on your free time?
I like to travel and I like to do photography and video productions of one kind or another.
If you'd like to talk to the school psychologist, please come see your counselor and we can make a referral.
Let's take a dip.
Hey Santa Sue, Jack Wilson here to talk about synchronized swimming, a woman's only sport. Let's go talk to Santa Sue's own Grace Krasmier with more on the story.
So synchronized swimming is like water polo and ballet, but you have to hold your breath and you're upside down. Oddly enough, even though it's swimming, we don't compete during the summer, and we compete between like February and July. So I train with a team 10 hours a week, and it's pretty rigorous. We have to get promoting and help other people to join our team because it's not very popular.
Do you plan on making this a career?
I don't think so because it's really difficult, so I'll probably just do it on the side because it's really fun.
A lot of air.
Many great dances occur in the winter. Littering is illegal.
Don't be a delinquent.
I am literal trash.
So trash. I'm like garbage.
Like, you know, they left me here because I'm supposed to be in the trash can.
You're
seriously,
so much
you're
trash.
Such trash. You're
I'm such trash.
You do not understand. You're not getting me. Like, I am trash.
What are you guys doing here? Lunch is over.
We're trash.
We're trash.
Throw away your trash.
Here's the backstory on another local band.
Hey, Santa Sue. I'm Francisco Saucita, and I got the sauce on Santa Sue's very own jazz combo. Let's hear about it.
Hey there, Santa Sue. We're the jazz combo. I'm Gohan Ruiz, and I play guitar.
I'm Matt Latta, and I play keyboard.
I'm Noah Unterberger, and I play drums.
What are some of the groups that have inspired you?
The Ray Brown Trio and John DeVersa.
I really enjoy and emulate Bill Evans, Herbie Hancock, and some Snarky Puppy stuff.
Right now, what I'm blasting is a lot of George Benson and Gucci Mane.
And Steely Dan!
What makes you different from other jazz bands?
I think we play a more raw and aggressive style of jazz. And it's not just jazz, I mean, we do a lot of like, you know, hip-hop stuff, a lot of like...
Waka Flocka.
We do Waka Flocka covers, and like video game song covers, so we play just about everything.
And what I really enjoy about Jazz Combo is the ability to jam on the spot and be spontaneous and come up with something entirely new, even for songs that might be like pop songs or like hardcore rap.
Back to you in the studio.
Don't you hate those other kids that live in your house?
You mean like brothers and sisters?
Yes, ugh, them.
I've always wanted a little brother.
Really? Well, here's your chance. Big Brother, Big Sister is a Santa Ana High School tradition. Our former assistant principal, Mr. Buckle, came up with an idea for the seniors and incoming freshmen to interact in a way that the freshmen feel comfort and stability in their new high school home.
Hi, I'm Catherine Montgomery.
Hi, I'm Tatiana Nakajan.
Hi, my name is Kayla Hoffman, and I am a big sister.
Big Brothers and Big Sisters started as a way to help freshmen transition into life at high school.
I signed up last year in my English class, and we did a few meetings, and then we got to meet all of our freshman babies.
Being a big sister is super rewarding, and I love meeting all the new underclassmen that are going to be seniors someday.
So having that contact point with someone who's been here a while and knows what the campus looks like and where stuff is really kind of eases that transition.
If you guys ever have the chance to become a big sister or big brother, you should do it because it's a lot of fun and it's rewarding and freshman.
Selection happens basically if you sign up and you have a good academic and discipline record.
Did you finish last night's homework?
Yeah, but sometimes I could use a little help.
Hi, Santa Sue. I'm Morgan Roberts, here with Sarah Tran, the president of CSF, to talk about the new semester. So, what is CSF?
CSF stands for California Scholarship Federation. It's a club based on your academic achievement.
CSF usually meets on the first Wednesday of each month at lunch in the activity room.
When are applications due for the new semester?
Well, we're collecting applications for the new semester, which means that freshmen can now apply. They're due Friday, January 22nd. We're having a meeting on Wednesday, January 20th at lunch in Mrs. Hazelwood's room, where you can come learn more about CSF, ask questions, pick up an application, turn in applications.
Don't forget to go to their website and check for more information about CSF and applications. Back to you in the studio.
Vegans don't get to enjoy your everyday winter drinks.
Hey there, Santa Sue. I'm Johnny DeMarla, here to offer a vegan substitute for a popular winter treat, hot chocolate.
What?
Vegan hot chocolate's a thing?
Why, yes. Believe it or not, vegan hot chocolate is a thing.
I thought vegan food was nasty.
Why would you do this to us?
All right, you know what? I just need to show you in the kitchen. Come on. Kitchen's this way. So welcome to my kitchen. What? Yes, I know I'm in my pajamas, but what better way to have hot chocolate than to snuggle up in your favorite cozy pajamas, am I right? Anyways, to start off your recipe with vegan hot chocolate, you're going to need 3/4 to 1 cup of almond milk or rice milk or soy milk. I prefer almond milk because it gives it that richness, but if you have a nut allergy, there are always substitutions out there. You're going to pour this milk into your cup. You're going to put this milk in the microwave for about 1 minute. So we're going to add 2 teaspoons of sugar. We're going to add 1 tablespoon of cocoa powder. Just a little bit. You always want to have a 2-to-1 ratio of sugar to cocoa powder because cocoa powder is fairly bitter. Okay, we're just going to stir that together. And now that it's all stirred together, you want to put it in the microwave for about 30 seconds, just so it all comes together.
Yeah.
Mmm. That is so good. You guys, I hope you guys learned something today. Do not judge something before you actually try something. So next time on V Treats, we're going to learn how to make vegan mac and cheese.
There's a new regulation in place.
Hey, Santa Sue, Ryan Rogers here. If you have something on campus you shouldn't have, what do you do? Let's go talk to Mr. Torty for more.
So, Mr. Torty, what is the Safe Harbor program? Safe Harbor is a this idea that if you find that you are in violation of some set of rules, and there's a particular set that it applies to, you can actually take action to prevent yourself from being in trouble if you're caught with something that you're not supposed to have on campus. I'll be real clear about it, though. You know, let's say that you've got a lighter. You know, there's any number of reasons outside of school that someone might have a lighter. You're lighting birthday candles or something like that, and then you drop it in your pocket, and then you go to school the next day and you forget that it's there. Safe Harbor protects you from getting in trouble for having that. That's contraband. You can't have it on school. But if you find that you have it, if you report that and bring it directly to an administrator, they'll confiscate it, and then we'll turn it over to your parents at the end of the day. It does not cover things that you have no reason to have. For example, any kind of a bladed object that is unnecessarily large. I mean, a pocket knife you might use on the weekend when you're out camping, leave it in your backpack, come to school, and then you see it there when you're getting your homework. The right thing to do is to turn that over. If you've got like a 7-inch, you know, serrated edge knife, that's a different thing, and we would deal with that differently. That has no business being on campus at all. Same, if you're in possession of something that the law says you cannot be in possession of, then, we have to respond. If you find yourself in a situation where you believe you might be in possession of something that doesn't belong at school, and we all know what those things are, take the initiative, you know, and reach out to a member of the administration, myself, Ms. Ledesma, Ms. Maya, and explain, you know, why this is here, and then we'll take the actions that are necessary to protect you and importantly, every other student on campus.
And that's the way it is.
January 13th, 2016.
Have a colossal day, Santa Sue.
Jam Club presents Crank Up the Volume, a rock concert at 7 p.m. this Friday in the MUR. It's going to be like nothing you've ever seen before. It's going to be totally awesome.
Tickets sold outside the student store for $5 for students and $10 for adults.